Hi, welcome to this special episode of Singapore Idol.
Absolutely. Now, in tonight's show, we're going to be tracing the top two finalists' journey from day one, queuing up at Cathay Cineleisure, to the moment that they were named as the top two finalists.
And Chief Judge Ken Lim will be here to answer all your burning questions. And also, watch out for encore performances by the top two finalists.
Yeah.
Are you ready? From the 3,000 over that came for the Singapore Idol auditions and also 15 weeks of voting, we've come up with this, the top two finalists.
Woo! Boy, before we go any further though, here's a quick recap of last week's show and the moment we revealed your top two finalists, one of them will be your Singapore Idol.
The idols showed what they were made of as they sang their favorite songs.
I guess you deserve all the cheers you're getting because you're in great shape, your voice is in great shape. That was a great opening act, it was just great.
I just want to do what I really want to do, which is have fun on stage. I can feel it coming in the air
tonight. Oh no. That was a very intense, a very fantastic interpretation of that song. You don't necessarily have to be a fantastic singer, but you need to have some kind of special quality, and I think you've got that.
What Dick was trying to say is that you have the X factor.
That's a big compliment coming from Ken. Every performance, you should be doing it as if it's your last, especially on this show. So, I mean, I'm just going out there and I'm going to pour out, you know, my heart and soul into this song. Seems to me some Fridays,
it's just a straightforward interpretation of the song. You got to add something more.
Party technically was very good. But I think Dick has a point. And do you know what is the solution? Fall in love.
I got into the song and must fall in love. Every little thing she does is
magic. Everything she do just turns me on. In the course of this competition, you have found a voice. You found a kind of a way to sing in a very cool way. You've become the cool guy of the show. So I think what you like now is, you know, in your fast numbers, it's just not exciting enough.
Every little thing you do is magic.
Thanks, Joe.
I'm sorry your idol journey has ended tonight, Jasmine.
I'm really, like, feeling very satisfied to have come this far, and I wouldn't have done this without the help of my family, my friends, my fans.
Hadi and Jonathan, you are top two finalists.
For the top two finalists, Jonathan and Hadi, they were a step closer to achieving their dreams.
I'm so happy he achieved his dream because this is really something he wanted to do so much. He has always wanted singing to be his career and he's almost there now. And I got to thank everybody who has believed in him and helped him to go this far.
I hope both of them will do their best. Eventually, in any competition, there's going to be only one winner, right? But at this stage, I think both of them are winners now.
I'm happy! My heart was like beeping so fast. I nearly want to cry.
Jonathan! He's really the best.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your top two finalists, Jonathan Leong and Hadi Mirza.
Yeah!
This is so exciting. Yeah. Okay, Jonathan, questions for you. What was going through your head when it was revealed that you made it to the top two?
I went, phew.
Phew?
Yeah.
Phew.
And the first thing that went through my mind was that I wanted to thank everyone. You know, I had a slip of paper in my pocket, actually. You know, a long list.
Those Oscar awards, thank you speech. Okay.
To thank everyone who brought me to where I am.
Right.
And especially the voters at home.
Of course, yeah.
Yeah, people who even put in one, you know, one vote.
Of course, every single vote counted, right? Yeah. Hadi, what about you?
Me? Oh,
what went through your mind when it was revealed that you were the top two?
I wasn't quite sure whether I would get into the finals.
No.
But once you announced that that me and John, you announced that I'm into the finals, I'm like, yeah!
Yeah!
Yeah,
I know.
Woohoo! Yeah. I was happy.
Very happy, overjoyed. Okay, now you guys had a real busy week, you know, since you were named the top two finalists. Let's talk about sleep right now. John, have you had any sleep? How much sleep have you had?
not enough sleep.
Yeah?
But I guess the drive and the adrenaline, the passion pushes you further than you know. further than I thought was possible for myself.
And Hadi, have you had any time to relax and, you know, some time out since you made it to the top two?
This whole day, I've been really jittery and I've had no time to actually, like, compose myself, like, sit down and relax. I kind of, like, fell asleep.
Yeah,
like
he's been napping throughout the day.
Catching the wings in between, right?
Okay. That's what you're going to do, right? Because you are hot and you're busy and all that, you have to just catch your wings whenever you can.
Yeah.
And like you say, when you get on stage, adrenaline just gets you going and you're up there and you just do your job.
All right. It's not caffeine.
It's not.
It's adrenaline.
Yeah.
All right. Now, you guys, you know, started this journey back in February. And from the auditions till now, here is their journey.
The search for this year's Singapore Idol began way back in February.
My name is John, I'm a student.
My name is Hadi, I'm gonna go all the way.
Tell me quando, quando, quando.
You're the person with the most charisma I've seen so far.
My eyes won't let me hide.
You have a very nice tone.
I will see you next round.
The next hurdle both Jonathan and Hadi had to cross was the theatre auditions.
You're in!
Then, they were both sent to the Singapore Idol boot camp to get into tip-top shape for the piano shows.
All those here to support Hadi, give it up!
Jonathan!
Next, it was time to showcase their talents in front of the whole of Singapore and win their votes in the piano shows.
The first one to be the top two off, Jonathan. Hadi!
In the top 12, it was more challenging as they had to deliver their songs from different genres in the spectacular show.
Check out the lights, man.
Over the 10 weeks in the top 12, Jonathan and Hadi won the hearts of the people and emerged as the top two finalists. Watching
the ships. I've always loved music. Ever since I was growing up, I've been exposed to a lot of music. I knew that I wanted to be on the stage and to sing for people.
And I said this to myself once, I'm only gonna join the competition once. And if I don't make it, then I don't make it. If I have the chance to make it, I'm gonna go all the way. Every little thing she does is
magic. Everything she do just turns me on. When we try and produce an artist, it's not about the power, the range, or anything else, but the ability to personalize yourself. I think from Unforgettable to Snow Patrol to what you did tonight, you managed to actually do that and do it very well.
Thank you.
You are vocally very reliable.
Thanks, John.
You are the top two finalists. Congratulations.
What a journey! Woo. Okay, you look back at the video, you said, that was me? I saw John going, ah, yeah, my hair! And Hadi going, huh. Okay, the top two finalists have been through a lot to make it this far in the competition.
Absolutely, but they would not have been able to go this far, you know, without the support of their parents.
Parents. Let's welcome Jonathan's parents, Mr. Joseph Leong and Mrs. Mary Leong, and Hadi's parents, Norazman Yunus and Mardiana Ahmad.
Okay.
Welcome to the show. Give them a big round of applause. Come on, show some love.
All right. Let's talk to Mr. and Mrs. Leong first. Now, what are some of the ways that you supported Jonathan throughout this journey?
Oh, okay. Jonathan has been away from home most of the time since this journey starts. Not enough of rest, not enough of sleep. What does all mothers do?
Cook porridge.
No. Brew yang teh. Make tonic soup.
Whoa.
Nourish him again.
All right.
Someone to love, someone to love. Okay, let's talk to Hadi's folks right now. And how have you guys supported Hadi during the course of this competition?
We try to do what most of the parents did.
Uh-huh.
As a parent, we support moral and physical. And once a week, when we come back, try to cook the favorite food for
What's
him.
His favorite food?
Yeah.
What's
a lot.
There's
so many.
I know, he's a typical Singaporean. Okay, okay, come back to Jonathan's parents. What are some of his favorite food?
He likes a lot of soupy stuff.
Soupy stuff?
Yes, soupy Ooh. Stuff.
That's yeah. why he's so fit and trim.
You know? Anyway, it's in the family. We all like soupy stuff.
You all like soupy stuff?
Yes, we
all the like soupy family. All right, now there's also plenty of sacrifices. Plenty of sacrifices. What are some of the sacrifices that you made, Mr. and Mrs. Leo?
What we have done for Jonathan, we would not consider them sacrifices. Mm. Especially compared to what his fans has done for him. Week after week, all his fans has been supporting him during his road shows, making banners for him, you know, sending him all their well wishes. And especially last week, you know, those who participate in the trailer has to be at the shooting scene at something like 6 a.m. in the morning.
Wow.
So what we feel is the real sacrifice.
That's true.
Just compared to us, we are yeah. nothing, seriously.
Yeah.
Oh, that's very, very, yeah. very humble.
Good work, friend. Yeah. Good work.
Yeah. Very humble. Very humble. And I noticed one thing that John's dad has a vote, yeah. John, vote for Singapore Idol like yeah. sticker. Yeah. Does this come with the shirt or you iron on or what? Where does this? John has a supermarket now. He is.
we leave it to your imagination.
My imagination can be very wild, you know.
Okay, we'll tell you.
Okay, tell us, please.
It's stickers.
Stickers?
Yeah. Right.
Okay, so you made the stickers and you iron it on, is it?
Yeah, no, you just peel it off.
You just peel it off. You can stick it anywhere shirt. You like.
Right. Oh, can so you put your skin also on your forehead? Yeah. Oh, like that. Okay, there you go. There you go! Vote for John! And, okay, so Hadi's folks right now, what are some of the sacrifices that you guys made, though?
It's what Mr. Leong said for the... supporters. And this is what I intend to say also, actually. And anyway, what my sacrifice is just a little. Mm. And I think...
Without fans, there's no Hadi.
What is Hadi, actually?
Thank you.
So anyway, we are still grateful. And thank you to the fans, what they have done so far for Hadi.
Yeah. Okay, we are now going for a break. When we return, we'll have all 12 idols back together again on stage. Stay tuned on 5.
The new wave of...
Welcome back on this very special episode of Singapore Idol. We look at the Idol journey through the eyes of the top two finalists. But now, though, it's a reunion. Yeah, we've got all the idols. Say hello to these guys. We got Norman Then. We got Gail Nerva. Emily Khan. Jay Lim. Rahima Rahim. Matilda De Silva, Noel Mighty, Jokin Gomez, Paul Tuhir, Jasmine Kai, and of course your top two finalists, Jonathan Leong and Hadi Mirza. Okay, we're going to ask the top 10 here the questions about the top two here. This is going to be quite interesting. Aha. Let's start with Norman. Since you were quite close to Jonathan and Hadi, is there anything about them you can share with us?
When I was doing the top 12, when I was out, right?
Yeah.
Jonathan sort of promised me that he'll work as hard as he can to get to the top 12, to the final show.
Final show for you.
To the final show for me. And he did lah. He's quite lucky he didn't break his promise. And also, Hadi, we used to share this superstar joke,
that's
superstar
right, that's
song.
Right, that's right.
And we used to say that, no, we are not superstars yet, we are superstar. I guess now he's a superstar. Yeah.
Yeah. What do you say about that, Hadi?
We're all superstars.
Let's ask Matilda a question right now. Matilda, I understand you rooted for Hadi and Jonathan to be in the top two. Now they're in the top two, how do you feel?
I'm just really proud of these guys. I mean, like, I know them as like friends and brothers and everything, and we all make fun of each other, but I'm gonna get soppy now. You know, like, I'll always be sending them SMSs, right? like, you know, all those inspirational, reach for the mountain, you know, the peak of Everest. It's just a little bit more. Give it all you got. So, you know, yeah. Yeah,
I'll be reading it and or John will be reading it.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Powerful words from her.
And then before you know it, you find yourself floating on air. What is going on? I'm going on
exactly. Air. So like, you know, I'm just so proud of them and I'm so excited to watch on like, you know, the finals, right? These guys just blossom into these beautiful flowers.
Okay. Whenever you say flowers, we think of jasmine straight away.
I know, I know. Okay.
But let's come to Paul. Paul, share with us some moments. Share.
They're like really my big brothers.
Cool.
Now, both of them have always been taking care of me, and yeah. I don't know. They really inspired me in some ways. Like when I really was like giving up hope with a lot of things, they always tell me press on and everything, and they made me learn a lot of things. Yeah, and I kind of like I'm educated by them.
You're about to tear. Oh my goodness. Okay, Jasmine, let's go over to you right now. You're in the top three. How did they treat you? Come on, the real truth now. How did they treat you?
Okay, seriously, they really took care of me like big brothers do.
How?
I guess they're always looking out for me. Yeah,
how?
And well, they do give, like, they do gang up against me in this way, you know?
So they do bully you. You want to show everybody how they gang up on you? Ready? Go for it, go for it. What they use is, what you're watching now is they use the elbow to hit the thigh bone, which is very ticklish and very painful. Okay, stop!
Stop!
Thank you. Get back. Back. Down, Simba, down. So that's ticklish. So, yeah. If there's any bruises, it was because of that. So do you do it back to them?
I try to, but you know, it's two guys, so it's quite tough. Yeah, and I get that like every Wednesday and Thursday.
Every Wednesday and Thursday they do that. Why? Okay, in the first place, why did that happen?
I don't know, he started it.
Huh? It was John?
Are you sure it's me? Very ticklish.
Is Hadi ticklish as well?
Yes.
No!
You know, we should have before the idol competition, we should have them sitting on the chair and tickle until we get on. The one who gives up first will be the second place.
I know.
How about that? We should do that.
Because it eases the stress.
Another
it eases
season.
The stress. Because we do it when we're having rehearsals.
Uh-huh.
And the day of the results show.
Okay.
So we do that to, you know, just lighten up.
Stress reliever.
Okay. But, you know. It's the most relieving for her.
It is. I noticed how much she's smiling now. It's amazing.
It's always targeted to me, you know?
Okay. Maybe before the rehearsals or the actual grand finals, Dan and I will go to your room and just do this for about half an hour and then get you all de-stressed. Jay, share some moments with us about these two guys.
Well, I think there's really nothing to share because some of us were like think that will these idols will it be another person off camera, but the fact is if you have been following the idol extras and if you're on idol on demand,
yeah,
and these guys are very real and whatever they do, it really came from their heart. Like John, when he performed, like he's like this cool dude. But actually, on his own, he's quite a little cute the boy. So he like when you see his favorite like Yong Tau Hu soup, like he's like, oh, so nice.
You can do it. Okay. Hadi is gonna do it for us.
Oh my god, Yong Tau Hu is so nice.
Yeah, you know, what about Hadi then?
Yeah, I know how to please him then. And Hadi, right? Some would say that like, he really, like, he act cool on stage when he performs, like, but he don't act cool. He's really a cool dude. Really.
That is so lovely. Okay, moving along. Emily, can you help us comment on the fashion sense of John and Hardy? Start with John first.
Oh yeah, when I first saw him, he used to wear like, he'll wear like jeans with like dragons, you know, those really big dragon palm.
So what about Hardy? He was wearing pants with a lot of sheep and mutton and ketupat or something, isn't it? Pandan leaf.
Well, because he's got really broad shoulders, so he basically looks good in everything.
Yeah, let's do a quick measurement. And we're shifting along to Jonathan now.
Same! Very good, very good. Okay, so... It seems to me, I mean, this is the second season of Singapore Idol.
Yeah.
But correct me if I'm wrong, but these 12 guys come across as one tight-knit family.
Very close.
That's very nice. If these guys and girls haven't spilled enough beans about the final two, here are more candid moments involving the top two finalists. This is the first time you are looking at the unseen footage.
This is good.
And your host, Jonathan Leong, for pit stops.
And the
toilet hole. Here we are. And come right in.
This is our new show.
You know, Toilets United.
With our own pit stop, John.
Oh, can we do this pose? The girl beside me, she used to be my baby. But right now, this is my baby.
Oh no, you ain't talking about me like that, yo.
Get up, man. Get out of the car.
I ain't
having you in my
it's
car, man.
My
just get out of the car, man.
Should you like it?
Hey, get your back off my bed, man.
Ow!
Please vote. Hardy Mirza.
Jonathan Leo. Hi, Karen. It's Patricia. Yes, cut it out. This is really embarrassing.
Who messed up my bitch?
I don't know, John!
This is a new thing that hotels are doing, you know, this new water, you know, it's very cleansing.
Excuse me.
Our segment on pit stop peeing, and it's been a great one. All of us enjoy ourselves here at the expo,
just, like,
having a pee. Back to you, Daniel.
All right.
You guys are just basically goofballs.
In a nutshell.
You guys are fans of WWE.
A little bit. The older ones, the old school ones.
Like.
Hulk Hogan, you know.
Hulk Hogan, Macho Man.
Undertaker.
The Warrior.
Ultimate Warrior. That was so cool. In the meantime, the top two finalists will now do a song each. The songs are special because they sang them at the piano show.
Yeah.
That was their first performance, which won them the viewers' votes. But before they sing, let's bring out a very special guest. Oh. Someone who's been a very important part of the Idol journey.
Thank you.
No, Chief Judge Ken Lim, everybody.
Right. Yeah.
Hadi,
In the piano shows, you sang Heaven by Bryan Adams. This is what the judges said the first time you first sang the song. Flo said, quite close to heaven, very steady and anchored delivery. I like it, it was nice. Ken, do you remember what you said to him?
Briefly.
Yeah, okay, what did you say?
Briefly. I think something to the extent that he reminds me of a lounge singer or something like that.
That's right, that's right. And how did you feel about those comments then?
Yeah, I felt they were quite just for that moment. Okay. Because true enough, I was quite comfortable with myself. Mm. Or maybe like what Ken always says, it's like too, playing it too safe.
Yeah. You know? Too much in your comfort zone, right?
Yeah, I think in this competition, you really have to push yourself. And I'm getting to know that it's quite tough. Yeah, it's not easy. Yeah.
But the rewards are amazing, isn't it? Once you push yourself and you deliver.
Yes.
Okay then, speaking of delivery now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Hadi Mirza with Heaven. Ken, this is the second time you're seeing this performance. Your comments on his performance now?
I think he wasn't very aware of what he was supposed to be like as a professional performer. He has the experience of being a club act. Mm. He controls his voice very well. But I think this is the very first time that he realizes that he has to go further than that. Mm. You know, and I think he did very well so far.
Now it's over to Jonathan. Okay, Jonathan, you sang If You're Gone by Matchbox. Oh, thank you. Matchbox 20. Dick said, now that was very moving. I would say easily top 10. What the hell, top 5? Ken, at that time, you said, I think you're gonna do very well, all right, but try to improve, try and find that identity. What did you say that?
I think the identity factor is what your strength is. So you really need to work on that because it doesn't take rocket science to know that you have the appeal. But the problem was back then you didn't know how to use that. And it's getting better, like I say, over the last 3 weeks especially.
Okay then, so bring on your charms then, and ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jonathan with If You're Gone.
I think I've already lost you. I think you're already gone. I think you're wrong. I think you're already leaving. It feels like your hand is on the door. I thought this place was an empire. Now I'm relaxed, but I can't be sure. I think you're sorry. I think we should try. I think I could need this in my life. But I think I'm just scared. Do I know too much? I can't relate, and that's the problem. How I'm feeling. If you're gone, then maybe it's time to come home. There's an awful lot of breathing room, but I can hardly move. If you're gone, then maybe you need to come home. Won't you come home? There's a little bit of something in and everything in me. Now you say if you're gone, then maybe you need to come home. Won't you come home? There's a little bit of something in and everything in you. Something me in you.
Ken, your comments on his performance this time around?
Oh, a lot more confident. A lot more confident. You know, they went through very intensive public scrutiny while they were in the competition. I think they deserve to be where they are, you know, and I'm very proud of them.
Okay, we're going for a break. When we come back, Ken will face the top 10 and answer their question and answer more questions from the fans. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back on this very special episode of Singapore Idol, the journey of the top two. If you just tune in, why? We have a special guest. The journey wouldn't have been possible if not for the advice of the Singapore Idol judges. And the person who makes viewers hang on to every word is none other than Ken Lim, everybody. Show some love, Ken Lim. Okay, more questions for you, Ken. What do you think about Singapore's choice for the top two?
With all due respect to you guys, I think Singapore made the right choices.
You probably have advice for these two, probably one of the greatest moments in their career.
You know, you cannot suddenly be like a major superstar. It takes time. But I think the idol journey is the beginning of a new stage in your lives. I think what's important is be yourself and do your best.
We go over the top 10 now, and some of you may have some questions for Ken as well, I'm sure. We'll start off with Jasmine. Jasmine?
Ken, is for the two guys there. What are some of the qualities that you know see in the final two boys that will carry them far in the music industry?
What? I think it's pretty obvious, isn't it? By now, I mean, if you look at them, they are much better than who they were then. They have improved. I think as far as Hardy is concerned, he's no longer a club singer, now a concert performer. And then as far as Jonathan is concerned, I think he has what it takes to compete commercially.
Everybody, many thanks to Ken, please. But don't go away yet. It's over to Daniel, who is in the audience. He's with some people who have some more questions for Ken. What's your name?
Sabah.
Sabah, what's your question for Ken?
Why are your comments always so harsh to the idols?
Okay, put it this way. If I were to be nice to them, they would go home happy, go to sleep, wake up and pretend that nothing has happened. Now, if I bruise their ego, they would think a lot harder and they would improve. Simple.
All right, and what's your name?
Matthew.
Matthew, I'm sure you have a burning question for Ken. Go ahead.
Ken, you manage talent, so what kind of qualities are you looking for in the artists so they can market themselves overseas?
What kind of qualities? I think drive. Drive, at the end of the day, if that certain individual wants that much to make it, it's not so simple, because it really means that you're willing to sacrifice and work hard, you know, and at any expense. So the dedication is something which I'm looking for.
Okay, and right now it's back to Gurmit.
Okay, thanks very much. Thanks, audience, for asking the questions. Thank you, Top 10. Thank you, Top 2. And thank you, Ken. Woo! On a Singapore Idol special, The Journey of the Final Two. We are 4 days away from the grand finals, which is happening at the Singapore Indoor Stadium on the 24th and 25th September. And we have been swamped with emails from fans who have questions for the top two idols, and I tell you, we have to get into this. So let's get into it.
Yep.
Here is the first email from Anne-Marie, and it's from Jonathan. Okay, what are some of the challenges during the competition? Did you ever expect to be in the grand finals when you first took part in Singapore Idol? John?
Thanks for the question, Anne. No, I didn't expect to come this far. So it's really a dream come true for me, and I hope to do my best.
Okay. And our second email is from Christine Lowe. It's for Hadi. So, what was the biggest obstacle you had to overcome during the competition? Hadi?
I think the biggest obstacle, I think, is actually bettering my previous performance every single week. And I think that's really difficult, yeah. And you have to, like, constantly have have your focus on your performances, and it's really difficult.
Okay, all right. I can
just trying to get that. Better every single week. It's
very hard. It's very hard. Yeah, it is. This one is from Susan Tan, and it's for Jonathan. Jonathan, how have you been preparing for the grand finals?
Basically, the preparation began throughout the whole competition, drinking lots of water and taking care of myself health-wise and making sure that I stay in good form and try to get as much rest as I can as and when we have the time to. And also to listen and review all my old performances to see where I gone wrong and what I can improve upon and make sure that, you know, I deliver the best show that I possibly can come the finals.
Are you visualizing something in your head, you know, like you're imagining 7,000 people in front of you and are you
Yeah, I'm doing that. I'm doing a lot of visualization here and there. It helps because it helps to calm my nerves down so that I, on the indoor stadium, I wouldn't be so taken aback by such a huge crowd. So I'm trying to play it through my head and to make sure that things don't go wrong.
Next question is for Hadi. It's from Gopal. Yeah. And Gopal says, how are you feeling as you get closer and closer to the grand finals?
As I get closer and closer, it's kind of surreal, man. You guys have to, like, we are constantly reminded, you know, top two, indoor stadium, you know. And at the same time, we are preparing for it, and the schedule is really tight. And I just feel happy right now that I get a chance to perform at the indoor stadium. That's really something, you know. Yeah, ooh. I'm just really excited. I cannot wait, and I'm really ready. And I'm just woohoo! Yeah,
ready to go. I mean, this is like almost every singer's dream come true. I mean, seeing the pubs or your lounge or your little gigs in the NUS, whatever you have. But nothing compares to it when you perform at the Singapore Indoor Stadium. 7,000 to 10,000 people just growing wild and enjoying every word that you're singing. I mean, it's gonna be awesome, isn't it?
I've been waiting for it, like, you know, all my life. You know, something like that. It's gonna be the biggest show, you know, on television, next to the National Day. And we're part of that, you know, so that's really great.
And the good thing about it is I find that the two of you are very good friends.
Yeah.
Which is nice. Is there any animosity between the two?
No, not for me.
No. These guys are good buddies backstage. We can vouch for that. Okay. Thanks very much, Hadi and Jonathan. And thanks, viewers, for writing in and giving us your questions. Big round of applause, please, for the two. Come on. Show them some love. Meanwhile, here are Norman, Gil, Emily, Jay, Rahima, Mathilda, Nurul, Joachim, Paul, Jasmine, and the top two finalists, Jonathan and Hadi C. Life is a highway.
Yeah.
Good night.
Life's like a road that you travel on. One day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside of the darkened door. The blues won't haunt you anymore. But the brave are free and let the soul come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate.
right down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.